Welcome to the See Highland Mountain Bus Journey Documentary.
This documentary will teach us some of Chinese culture, history involved in this particular temple, and certain traditions, celebrations handled in this temple. Come, let's join our journey to the temple from now on.
We are bringing you a live documentary presenting straight from our point of view, letting you experience the journey through the lenses to gain more knowledge and get to know other cultures in Malaysia. Let's get started. Let's go. To go to the temple, we need to head southwest on Persiaran to Dr. Ismail, then turn left on Jalan Kemang to make a U-turn at Persiaran to Ghazali Syafi'i, then turn right onto Jalan Dato' Sheikh Issam, followed by a left onto the Jalan Pantai. We arrive at our destination, See Highland Mountain Temple.
As we approach the temple, we follow the lead of our Chinese members as they have come to this temple before. They guide us on the path to the temple, sharing their cultural knowledge along the way. As some of us is a first timer, we are taking the time by walking slowly, seeing the temple entrance ambience that is full of Chinese culture. We also make sure all the discoveries throughout this journey are recorded. As can be seen upon arriving, there are a few buses arriving before us that belong to the travelling group. Most of them have mostly come from Thailand and Singapore, as their temples are closer to the border than others, which contains a lot of cultural value and long history. This resulted in the temple becoming more crowded than usual as there are more tourists and tour guides. Even though most of the time the guides are explaining in Mandarin, they are also at times they speak in English, which helps us understand more about this temple. There are also some of them busy buying souvenirs from this temple. As we walk into the temple, it can be seen there is a lot of statue at the podium unlike before based on our Chinese member description. Apparently, this is because the main temple is under refurbishment. The architecture of this temple mainly is made out of wood and is in need of renovation as this temple has a long history. So, the owner decides to renovate it for the safety of the tourist or visitor and for its artistic consideration. Outside of this temple, there are a lot of statues and designs which link to Chinese culture. For example, the first statue is the god of the city, which is Cheng Huangyi, which is believed can guard the city, uphold justice and fairness. Next, Chai Shen Yi, also known as the god of wealth by its believer. Each of its believers hopes to get proper wealth without facing any bad consequences.
While exploring, we are interviewed with the well, then we found the description of it, which acts as information and reminder to the tourists and visitors. Our team member Aisha has recorded this video on higher platform, while other team member Nick Pariki to explore the area. As we explore the area, we also watch out our curiosity regarding the statue building and their building. All of us make sure to have a good look around the temple. The members are seen to taking a close look to see the details of certain architecture and its unique feature around the temple. As we can see, there are a lot of red color elements in its building and decoration. Some cultures in the Si Hailong Temple can also be seen in good condition despite the time. Seeing the tourists ring the bell, which symbolizes bringing good luck to themselves and their family members. This small statue represents the god in Chinese folk legend. The main god is Tai Shi Ye. Tai Shi is the Chinese term for the star directly opposite to the planet Jupiter during its roughly 12 years orbital cycle. Tai Shi is a protector which believed to reduce bad luck and bring good luck to people. It's the discovery of a remarkable white crocodile statue which believed to bring good fortune and luck. For these statues, it said that golden crabs could bring more luck and wealth to the believers.
These are the wishing cards that are used to write blessings. This statue is known as Yu Lao, and it represents a god who is thought to aid in marital matching. Since the bridge construction and the statue location was completed, a significant number of love locks have been hung along its length. These are being done with the hopes of having a successful marriage in the future. As the love lock leaves signs of its passage through time, we may determine from the films whether the lock is new or old. In addition to the love lock being hung, ribbons are also strung to the bridge. Even some of the ribbons are being fastened to poles or trees in the area. This location was created to give travelers and believers a spot to unwind and take a breather next to the Batu Pahat River. There are a lot of lanterns hanging because there are multiple temple celebrations going on the day we go. Due to the temple's natural surroundings, it has a relaxing impact on all who attend. The natural environments of the temple have a calming effect on everyone who visits.
我们先问你名字，OK？请问你的名字是什么？你在这边的职位是
？OK，我是叫杰森，然后我是这边的那个青年团团长，然后是这边，因为我们有做那个上网的东西，所以我是这边的网络负责人这样啊。
这间庙它是几时建成的？
我们的庙，如果你是讲注册的话，因为我们神庙会有注册，对吗？我们注册来讲的话是1983年，但我们在这个注册之前，我们其实就有这间庙了。所以如果是要推算下去的话，其实40-50年了。
40-50年。
这间庙40-50年了。
这个庙的创办人还是他的主坛呢是谁啊？
创办人是这个洪雅化，就是我的大伯啊，可是他人已经过世了。
人已经过世了。
对对对。
OK，这家庙有改过名字吗？它的原名是什么？
原名是布德坛大伯公，然后过后我们改成布德坛四海龙王大伯公。嗯。
这样它这边有什么故事可以让你们想要起庙这样？
OK， 它的故事是这样子，就是讲我们以前你可以看到我们这边的河这边都是渔村。OK， 我们这边以前他们就是靠这种捕鱼为生的。OK， 然后他们在出海之前，因为我们知道就是海在海上面捕鱼啊会有风险啊，然后有时可能捕鱼捕不到啊，或者是一些天气因素啊，所以他们都会出海之前他们都会习惯性就是拜神。OK， 通常都会拜大伯公或者妈祖都有。所以就是他们在拜出海然后去捕鱼啊这样子。所以我们这边原本是一间小庙，然后以前是供一个大伯公小小的金身，然后就拜他们就出海就会拜，然后拜了，其实都有，就是他们的收获都有啊，然后都有顺顺利利啊，慢慢就是很多人来答谢，然后慢慢做成现在这样子。以前是小小间，慢慢做的。
可以。这样子，这样我刚才经过我观察，我有看到，我们这边有卖一些首饰啊、项链啊、挂物啊那些，这样有没有什么特别的内涵意思这样子
？OK， 其实我们华人来讲的话，我们都很相信风水。其实风水的话，我们其实马来人同胞他们其实也是会相信风水的。所以，我们这些叫做 crystal， 我们叫那个水晶啊，其实就是一个增加我们的能量的一个东西。所以，我们这边会有卖这些水晶，当然不是很全面，一些我们卖一些这种水晶，然后就是可能有些来拜拜的人，他们想要就是买这些水晶，可以过来看看这样子。
这样子，我们如果在参观这些庙的时候，有什么东西是不能做的吗？
参观神庙的话，其实参观神庙的话，我们的神庙其实是比较开放的。其实你们要，因为有些神庙他们是不可以对神明拍照，可是我们的神庙是 OK 可以。然后最主要就是可能看到神明的东西，或者是包括那边有一只白鳄鱼，对吗？那个白鳄鱼就是有些可能家长啊，他们带小 baby 来，他们会很像给小孩子爬上去，可是这个其实是对神明不尊敬的。所以我们来到神庙最主要的就是那些神明不要去可能用手去动它。可能我们就是用双手合十拜拜就可以了啊，就是那种有神像的东西，千万不要去乱碰，这样子就可以了。
好，这样，刚才我们讲到白鳄鱼，可以告诉我们一点关于白鳄鱼的故事吗
？OK， 其实白鳄鱼这个故事哈，它是传说啦。OK， 以前在巴都巴汉哈还没有开发啊，还真正是比较落后的时候，以前我们这个波斯莱那边有一个那个布特拉耶前面有一座桥，对不对？那座桥以前是没有那座桥的，所以我们这个巴都这个旧市区这边，我们要去对面的波斯莱。我们叫做对面港，我们要过去的时候，我们是要打船过去的。以前是没有那个叫桥，
没有桥。Okay，
so 就是以前他们要过河的时候，他们就要坐船。连传说是有一个人，他要过河的时候，他就没有船，他又很急着要过河，有一件急事要过河，然后就他看到那边一个大块的白色的木头 ，OK， 他就想都没有想就踩上去了。然后那个木头就跟他栽到对面来，可是他转头回去看的时候，其实是白色鳄鱼来的。OK， 这个只是传说啦。然后就是讲白色鳄鱼，我们白色在华人的文化里面来讲，这个白色其实我们象征是纯洁，然后包括幸运。因为白色的动物我们知道是有白色的 albino。OK， 白色的，我们如果是看到白色的鳄鱼或者是白色的什么动物都好，其实是很幸运的。白老鼠不要讲啦。OK， 然后白色的话 ，OK， 我们就是曾经有人在这条河里面看到白鳄鱼，因为这条河其实我们连着那个白鳄鱼最出名的地方，其实在三清港，三清港那边有个大伯公，它其实也是有白鳄鱼。其实我们这条河只有一条白鳄鱼这样子，它的白鳄鱼就是我们把它称为就是在这个河里面的守护神，一个河神这样子，
河神、
就是它是一个要讲尊贵，然后是稀有的象征啊。
好，这样子我们的这间庙跟其他的庙有什么太大的差别吗？还是关于什么东西有没有一些比较特殊的
特殊的
事迹？
其实每一间神庙都有它自己就是特别的东西啦，我们也没有就是比较特别，只是我们的优势其实我们就是在后面这条河上面啊，这个你可以看到就是现在的风景，包括这个气候其实也还蛮凉爽这样子，知道其实很多人喜欢来这些庙，可能就是因为我们这边是比较就是它的木的这些庙的结构其实是木的，然后其实也很难找到一间庙就是整个结构都是用木的，所以我们特别可能是这边跟靠河咯。那如果是很像讲神明灵验的话，那个其实每一间神庙都有他自己的就是灵验跟自己的这些善性这样子。
好，这样子我们这边可以看到月老像月老他是有什么特别的事迹吗？还是他的
月老是这样子，月老就是我们他是没有什么特别事迹，可是就是月老的话哈，其实因为讲这几年才比较兴这个月老 ，OK， 这几年比较年轻人哈会拜神哈，其实都是我要去神庙拜月老，我要去神庙拜月老。把我们这尊月老啊，其实已经十多年了，
10多年了
OK， 就是现在很多神庙会就是你看到 Facebook 啊，会有看到很多这些就是讲拜月老的东西，但把这我们的月老其实已经在10年前之前就已经有了这个月老，所以其实。来神庙我们其实要求的东西其实一个心灵寄托了，就是像我们要求就是可能一点我们的钱不够用啊，
财运，
我们求财 OK， 可能做工不顺啊，我们求顺利，然后跟很像来庙会就是其实华人的整个生活当中其实什么东西都可能会跟这个神庙息息相关，一个心灵寄托好像 OK， 那所以我们会有这个月老是求姻缘的，然后到生了孩子我们前面有那种送子观音啊，祝生娘娘啊，这样子就是心灵寄托，所以我们这个月老的话其实它是一个就是我们的那个 Christian 的那种丘比特这样子，它是就是掌管我们的这个姻缘的，所以我们这边会有这个月老就给人家来拜拜这个月老这样子咯啊，然后在网络上面的那个评论还不错啦，就是很多人讲哎蛮灵这样子
我们这边有什么特别的庆祝仪式还是什么纪念的日子这样子，他们会多久会庆祝一次这样？
我们的这些庆典啊，这些节目啊，其实都是每年一次的。OK， 我们主要庙会有三个主要的大日子。OK， 一个是刚才我讲的正月十五有捞鱼生。OK， 正月十五是元宵节，其实我们也叫做龙王的宝诞千秋。哦，对了，我们这个河里面其实龙王我们知道叫河神，叫
神
OK， 所以我们这个龙王、河神、海神，我们就是龙王，我们在这个庙也算一个主神这样子，因为我们靠河靠海这样子，所以我们龙王这是正月十五宝诞千秋，然后正月二三是我们的善财爷宝诞千秋，善财爷就是那种。啊，正月二三是三财爷宝诞千秋，跟八月十五是大丰宝诞千秋，所以我们这边主要三个这个宝诞
大日子
三个大日子啊，对，这是庙里面一年下来最多人的那种节日节目这样子。
可以，这样谢谢你的采访啊。
可以，谢谢。
We appreciate you sticking with us all the way to the end. I shall then express my gratitude to my traveling companions who are translator in charge Ricky, Steven, and Derek, camera assistant Farisha, Arnie, and Amirul, designated driver Edwin, Akram, Asia, and Umi, script maker Haris and Firyal, voice actor Daniel, Wazwan, Putri, and Shafika, film editor Ahmad, Chisung, Faiz, and Fatini. Then do enjoy our gallery walk, bloopers, and mission at the end of this video. Thank you.